I found CrossFit at the perfect timing. I found it when I needed that community feel. I needed to feel like I belonged and I was a part of something and there was a purpose for my life. Became more friendly, became a happier person, a healthier person because of CrossFit and the environment that I was putting myself into. I know that I had a good foundation because of my family and my mom and dad, how they raised me, but I got lost along the way, and CrossFit really helped me get right back on path and, you know, took better turns in the journey, and it's been an amazing ride. And fast forward 2 years after finding CrossFit, you know, I fell in love, you know, it changed my life in another way. I found Eric. After the first 2 years, it was one of those things where I was like, you know, this would be really awesome to open my own gym. But at the time, everything at the gym I was at was perfect. We were having fun, so the thought of opening my own gym was more of like long-term goal. Like, I could do this. And then as the years progressed, you know, people change, lives go in different directions. And I felt like that's what was happening at the gym. And it was one of those things where I was like, you know, the community wasn't as strong as it used to be. And so when that started to dwindle, I really felt the need to create that again. That became a dream. And it was still maybe 2 or 3 years where that dream was so far away. I didn't know how to get to it. I didn't know how to begin. And it wasn't until Eric really pushed me to get started that this dream started to become reality.
We have finally made it, four walls to call our own. I am very excited and I hope you're excited too. Please go to CrossFitTrainingYard.com and check out the Founders Club. We would love for you to be part of our community.
Finding a location was like a 2-year process. Like, now I can only see where we are today and know that this was the right decision. Everything happens for a reason. And so that wait was completely worth it. But it was hard. It was really hard. It was devastating at times. Now looking back, like, this gym is small, but it's the perfect size for me. And it's just cool. I think the most difficult aspects of owning an affiliate would have to be the lack of sleep, which takes a toll on everything else, and then your inability to have that extra time to spend with family and friends. But I know the benefits outweigh everything, and the most rewarding thing of having an affiliate is just to see people grow. It's truly to see people have PRs or challenge people to do things that they didn't think they could.
Yes! Yes! Drop.
accomplishment that they feel when they actually prove to themselves that they could. It's really cool. It's always been the most gratifying thing out of CrossFit from day one. Honestly, I don't think I am a great coach. I feel like there's so much more for me to grow. I feel like what makes me a decent coach is that I want to be treated on how I treat you. I want you to treat me how I'm gonna treat you. I'm gonna treat you good, right? And I'm gonna make sure that you understand that you mean something to me. And I think that's the foundation of being great. I think that, you know, being able to teach a squat and teach it really good, I'm getting there. But I truly believe in my heart that everybody is worth my time. And so I want you to feel important. I want you to feel like you are worth something. And I think that's important. I think gym owners miss that, miss the fact that these aren't just dollar signs that are walking in your door. These are humans.
About 2 months after I started at the training yard, I had to undergo colon surgery for to remove a tumor. It was cancerous. And during that time, Becca reached out to me via email to find out about my recovery and encouraged me to come in and work out at my own pace. But I had to come in and tell her that I was facing 12 rounds of chemotherapy. And that was really hard. But she didn't just say, okay, let me know how you are, come back, you know, make sure you come back. It wasn't like that. It was, come here, be here when you need to be here. Even if you're just sitting here and watching. That's huge. That's, for me, it's saying you have a place to feel like nothing's changing, and that I have a place to come back and recover. And that's a huge sense of relief to have that support. It's gonna be the most challenging AMRAP I'll ever have to do. And I'm not scared anymore.
I've been very fortunate to have a lot of training. You know, CrossFit HQ has taught me a lot about making sure that everybody who needs attention gets attention, and that's everybody in your class. Everything's tight. Press up, Jody, press up, press up. Heels, drive through those heels first, then go to your toes. Nice, Alex. All the way down, all the way down. Straighten your arms when you have the opportunity to straighten them. I understand if they're overhead, it's hard. Yeah, you weren't doing that. And let's see, 10 beautiful overhead squats. Oh. So, okay, stop. I get myself set. The first thing I'm gonna do, make sure everything is tight and pulled back nice and tight. I'm sliding down. Ready, drop. There we go, that's better. Reset. Toes. You're doing this. You're doing this. Look at my hips. Okay? You're doing this. I need you to do this. Not behind the bar, over the bar. There you go. There it is. Knees back. There you go. When you land, drive those knees out so that you have tension in the backside. You know, everyone's issues are important. We must address them. And so getting that fix every single class will create change down the road. And so it's just those building blocks to success that we need to build.
Nice and close, big jump.
There you go. Knees. Okay, we gotta really work. So every day you come in here, I want you in that hip circle. Bend over a little bit more and chest up. Get tight, yep. Oh, press up, press up, press up. Get tight, get tight.
I think the difference has been that Becca actually takes the time to individually coach. It doesn't matter how big the classes are or how small it is. She always makes sure she comes and corrects her form.
Yeah, you gotta fight for that position. Chest up, turn those armpits towards the ceiling. Punch the ceiling, punch. Okay. You're gonna have to fight for every rep. Or take the weight off so you can move a little bit faster. You can't limit your body on doing something because your mind thinks it's not possible. The human body is amazing and it can do amazing things if the mind is willing, at least willing to try. The goals are absolutely the same, there's just more goals to it. I want to go back to the games for the 8th time.
It's not stressful. If I don't make it for an 8th time, that sucks, but it's not the end of the world. And if I do make it, it's really cool, and it just adds to the special feeling I get from CrossFit. It doesn't define it, and I won't let it define me, so whatever happens this year, happens, and that's okay. But I will do my damnedest to do everything I can to get back to the games.
But I also run a very successful gym. It's just about finding a way and delegating and learning how to, you know, have other people take on more responsibility.
And going from here, straight down into that dip, okay? Keeping that barbell super close and then going right into the next rep, okay? Let's try it again, here we go.
Trust that they'll get that done.
I'm not re-dipping, all I'm doing is pulling my shoulders up, landing in that squat, standing right back up.
My goals for CrossFit Training Yard is to continue to grow the community. You know, we get together, we suffer, and a side benefit is we have fitness. And I really hope that we continue to grow this community as strong as it is.
Great. Whenever you think you're gonna have a bad day, it could always be this dog.
Yeah.
Oh, so cute.
Keep that feeling that people get of being special and meaning something to this gym and this community. I want people to know that they all belong.